Mowienatics. It's your boy, Tommy Mars. I'm back with a brand new Mori episode. Oh, yeah. I got some ice cold iced tea today. Here's what we're rocking on. Today, you and I, we're going to go through Mori's brand new EP, Signature. I'm sure most of you have heard it by now. It's amazing. Here's the thing. Here's the scoop. I am happy to announce that my interview with Morissette is going to premiere right here, YouTube, this Saturday. So check out the time zones. I'm in Eastern Standard Time Zone. It's 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. If you're in the Philippines, it's going to premiere 8 p.m. Philippines time zone. Okay? So 8 p.m. if you're in the Philippines. If you're in Eastern Time, that is 8 a.m. I don't want to confuse you because I'm a little confused too. But that's when it's going to premiere. So if you want to be around for the premiere and you want to chat, we're going to live chat a little bit, say hello, and all that good stuff. I hope you enjoy it. Another thing I want to add to that is I want to send a thank you to all Mowienatics, because as Mori and I were talking, she let me know that a lot of you got in contact and said, hey, Tommy Mars would be a good person to interview you, and he's a big fan of yours, and you guys really kind of got the word out to her and her team, and I just want to say thank you, thank you, thank you. I appreciate it so much, you guys trying to get the interview for me and stuff. It means a lot, and I just want to express my gratitude, because it really just touched me, and you guys are phenomenal. She speaks so highly of her fans, you guys, the Mowienatics. She's like over the moon about the response to Signature and just your guys' support. But you're going to see that on Saturday. You're going to see our entire conversation, and we talked everything from the EP to the Mowienatics to Jesse J. We talked about everything. It was great. It's a long episode. I think you guys are really going to enjoy it. But I just wanted to say thank you very much. I did not film anything at the beginning of it. It goes right into the interview. But I wanted to say thank you, guys. It means a lot. You guys are great, and it's awesome. So here's the other thing with Signature. So before the interview, I never go into an interview situation. And those of you that have been following me a long time, you know I interview rock stars all over the planet, right? But before I interview anybody, if we're talking about a brand new album, I always listen to the album because I want to talk about album notes. I want to talk about the production and stuff. Just like I do on this show, I like to talk to the artist about it. So I did that. And the thing was, I did not film myself doing it because that was me like really taking notes. I wasn't really, I didn't really want to pay attention to a camera or anything like that. I just needed to like have my notepad out, take notes, write about little things that kind of move me and stuff like that, questions I may or may not have. So what I'm doing today is, number one, I wanted to announce the premiere, but number two is I just want to listen to it with you guys, because I've been listening to it. Oh my gosh. Well, the first day it came out, I actually went on iTunes and bought it because I wanted it in my iTunes library, and I just been listening to it. I have my earbuds on, and this thing it's dynamic. As you know, it is dynamic. I actually mentioned to her about some of the songs, you know, favorite songs, and it keeps changing. And today I'm going to tell you something. So today I would say my favorite, I think it's Mirror. I don't know. I keep changing my mind. It's Phoenix is very special. Actually, you know what? They're all special. Let's get to it. Let's listen to this right now. And as we're doing our thing right here, this is kind of where I focus a little bit different. So I'm hoping to pick up some things, and let's go. That guitar right away. It's so now. I love it. I love it. Don't know when I last heard the sound of your sweet voice, but sometimes I hear it in my dreams. Your vision haunting me, this feeling so uneasy, caught somewhere in the in-between. What do I do with these? her vocal is so good. That. Oh, this song, her voice. And the production. That line. I mean, that's incredible what you just did. Nice harmony. Chills every time she hits that note. Oh. Shout out to her production team. When her and I talked, and I hope I'm saying this right, I believe it was Sergio that was produced it. What an amazing job. And then those guitars and everything that's in there. And then shout out to Dave and all the things that he does. Because it sounds like him and Mori really kind of put their heads together and write these things and just put out this product that we're hearing. Okay? This is, I'm telling you, man, I can put that up against anything. Anything that's out right now. To me, oh, that is something else. She is something else. That note at the end. I'm telling you, man, she is just special. And I told her that. I said, you are one of my four favorite female voices in the history of music. I mean, that is so special right there. There are so many things, even if you just go back right now, because the music, it just vibes. It's such a great vibe. Just to hear that, if you heard that a cappella, just what she was doing there, those runs up and down. I mean, she starts low and she goes high and she's just waterfalling down. She's amazing. All right, let's get to the second track. What a way to start an album, right? I mean, the first time you heard this EP, how many days ago? You had to be freaking out and saying, oh my goodness. All right, so this is Trophy. I did an episode on the visualizer a couple days ago. Oh, but we're listening to this one again. Oh, this song.
From me, I can shift, I can morph, I can fly, whatever
Nag guitar. All those. That steady bass. Oh, yeah. So good. I mean, this thing is banging. That is strong, that squeak at the end. Oh, yeah. And then she hits you with this. Woo. Love that bass.
When it's good, when it's new, when there's just so much to do, when we sing and we dance under the bright light of the moon.
And that block, it's just
bam.
Such a feel. I love this. Almost a jazzy R&B type feel. It's just, oh. That note, that note. Yeah. That's special. Oh, man. Her harmony drops in, drop-ins. I mean, oh. There's a lot of great harms going on.
Wow.
want control. Yeah, yeah. Oh, shout out to this guitaring. Come on. Come on. You can't tell me that's just not one of the best things you heard. It's just, it's, her vocals are so glossy. Those harmonies, especially right there. And I love that they let it play there right at the end. That's a great production choice right there. It's a great decision. It just sounds, it's the perfect way to end that. And it's such a cool, smooth jam. She was telling me that her producer is a great guitar player. No doubt, man. I mean, I like his tone, too. I like the tone of the guitar. I love everything he's riffing on there, too. You know, it's not like it's almost like with Mori's voice. Like, it's not like he didn't do something overly complicated to kind of mess up everything, but it's enough to know, yeah, this guy can shred. If he wants to shred, he can shred the guitar. Same thing with her voice. You know what I love about Mori? And I've mentioned this before. I love that she doesn't oversing every line. She doesn't need to. She already has one of the most beautiful tones ever in existence. She has a great tone. But man, when she pushes and goes for it, I love when she goes into the vibrato and then she backs off and comes out of it. You know why I love it? Because that's the control thing. I'm not saying everybody can vibrato, but sometimes when you get in that, you can do it and then end it. I think it takes, it's the more upper echelon special singers that can start straight, vibrato, come out straight, and maybe even throw in a little wiggle at the end. That's the more set thing I'm talking about. Yeah. All right, we're about to get to my current favorite song right now is Mirror. And her and I spoke about Mirror and how the fan reaction was to it. And I was like, I liked it right away. Ever since our conversation, I have to confess to you, I've been listening to it nonstop. And it's such a special song. There's so many things and there's a couple notes in there that I'm just like, oh gosh, it's so good. In fact, today I have this Spotify playlist called Ultra Music Bliss, of course. I mean, that's what I call it, Ultra Music. Only for me, it's the best of the best. So my favorite songs go on this Ultra Music playlist. And I just added two Mori songs to that playlist today. One was Trophy. And the other one I added, way up there, it's Mirror, man. This song is, I want the whole world to hear this. Let's listen to it now together. And it's that guitar, those notes.
Saw you face to face, I almost didn't recognize you.
Tried to and I love her flow.
And did not know what to say, but there was no way to avoid you. I tried to gather up the strength to say what's on my mind, but was speechless, frozen, trapped in time. I can't avoid you
forever. Yeah! And then the snow. This song. I love her double track voice right there. That's double track. And then hear that harmony? That high in there. Oh, yeah. know this song. That God, that high harmony. Oh. This song needs to be like number one on every chart. You know what I'm saying? Number one on every chart. Every single US, Philippines, South Korea, everywhere. It's that good. Mirror. This album is ridiculous. It right now, okay, so we're on Phoenix. You want a message? And it's those rundowns. Oh. There's a hope that comes with the morning. There's a chance to start over again. Just as long as our hearts keep on beating, there's some time left to win. So let's try. It's goosebumps, man. On the piano. Right there. That's production, baby. Oh, yeah. Oh, oh man. You know, it's so weird that I told Mori this. I said, I don't know really how or anything. Cause like, you know, obviously I don't know her, but I feel so proud. This album came out. It's been charting everywhere, like in so many countries. It's been charting up so high and so many people are listening to it. They're buying it. What an incredible voice. I mean, what you just heard right here, if you're watching this channel and you're watching me because maybe you're here for BTS or Harry or Marcelito or something, and you don't know Mori that well, what we just witnessed right there, that's incredible, right? I mean, even if like you're here for another artist, like I feel like by hearing what I just heard, and I've heard this already because, you know, we did an episode on Phoenix. Remember the video with the fireworks and stuff, which was incredible, by the way. I feel like this kind of performance should make anybody a fan. If you're a fan of music, if you're a fan of good voices, if you're a fan of harmonies and great production, I mean, this EP just really has it all. And that's the other thing, you know, I really do feel like there's something for almost everybody on this thing, because there's that chill vibe, there's the banging vibe, there's the message. And that's something that her and I talked about, actually, at length. We talked about the message with Phoenix, and, you know, she's got a great head on her shoulders, and I really feel like her and her team, they all mean well. They all mean, like, everything they say, you know? That's the feeling I got. And I don't think you're going to find a more humble, extremely talented artist like you're going to find like Morissette. That's, I know I'm biased because I'm such a super fan now, you know? I really am. But when you see somebody do something like on the Wish Bus, and if you see maybe a cover or something, a cover song, maybe a song you like, man, I really like what they did, and you become a fan. But I think that the crossover is when you start listening to, like, when they put out an original release, and then you start just vibing on that, but then you're hearing the nuances they do on that, their own special stuff on that, on their original songs. To me, it takes the fandom to a whole different level. And I encourage anybody watching this, if you're watching me because you just watched her on the Wish Bus, go give this EP a listen on your own. I know we just did it together. Put on the earbuds or get a really good set of speakers and listen to it. In your own time, you know, just listen to it and just do that thing. Man, I just close my eyes or I shoot hoops and I listen to this and I'm just amazed every time I listen to it. I've heard this already. I heard Mirrors so many times now, but I still get that pop every time she does those things, those harmonies, those runs, when she pushes and she hits those notes. It's incredible. Yeah, man. Morissette, she's something special. You guys are special too. This has been a great journey so far. I'm not going anywhere. Hope you're not going anywhere. Morissette's, she's not going anywhere. She's going to keep putting out music and we're going to love it because she's awesome. So here's the thing. If you're watching this one, if you haven't subscribe, hit the notification bell because I want you to be notified when the premiere happens. I mean, this video, it's important. You know, we watch these videos and we're all having fun together and all that. I get all that. To me, the most important thing out of all this is I finally got the interview with Morissette. I feel like I asked her a lot of questions that I've been wondering. I actually forgot a lot of questions and we joked about it at the end that I've been wanting to ask her. But, you know, I wanted to talk about Signature and stuff. But it's important to me that the interview gets out there, not for my sake or even the channel's sake, honestly. If you want to unsubscribe after the thing, that's okay too, okay? What I'm saying is I want her to get out there. I want people to see her personality, her words talking about these songs and the Mowienatics, the fans and everything. Do you know what I mean? It's important. I want people to see that side and see that, man, she is a genuinely great person. And, you know, what the heck, man? We're all here for the ride. I hope you join me on it. So make sure you get the notification and subscribe and all that good stuff. All right. Last thing I'll say is on social media, I've gotten a little more active talking about like these videos and interviews and stuff like that. So if you want to go follow me on Twitter or Instagram, you can DM me on Instagram or whatever. TOMMYMARZBAND, Tommy Mars Band. Those are my handles. Come follow me. I've been tweeting out a little bit more about this stuff. And we're actually having fun over there. We're having a lot of fun on Twitter, retweeting and talking. And I appreciate all the comments. And if I haven't got back to your, like responded back to your tweet, I'm going to. I will before Saturday. I will. It's just that there's been a lot coming in between both platforms. So I'm going to respond to all those. And I just want to say, I appreciate you too. I love the excitement for this interview with Mori. I've been waiting a long time. It's here. You guys worked hard. Thank you very much. I will see you next time. It's Tommy Mars. I'll see you Saturday.